Hi guys, welcome to Twitter's funny channel. In our last class, we saw how to work with the deposit function, how to work with the deposit form. In this tutorial, I'm going to teach how to work with the withdraw form. Okay, let's create another form which is a withdraw here. Just go and select the form. Let me name as withdraw. Here we no need to change anything else. The same thing we have just copy and paste. Here we just design the form as like this. Go to the form border that we select as none. The only stuff we have did here. Another thing, you just copy this one. Select this all the components. Just the same thing here. The only difference between deposit here, deposit in this form. In that withdraw form, there will be the option withdraw. Deposit means there will be the option deposit. Withdraw form, there will be the option withdraw. That is the difference between cash deposit form and cash withdraw form. Okay, so that another data will be same. Okay, account number, date and balance. Okay, so let me copy this one and paste on the withdraw form. Okay, the same thing. Here you have to, you need to change one thing here. One is here deposit. Here instead of deposit, you have to change as withdraw. That's it. Here also you have to change as withdraw. That's it. Here button also you have to change withdraw. Some spelling mistake. Okay, now what I did is, what I going to do is here the same thing. I'm going to do the coding part as well, the same coding. The namespace I'm going to paste here, withdraw form, the same MySQL namespace as well as the same connection. You have to call the same connection. Just copy and paste after the initialization component. After that, search also the same thing as we did in our previous withdraw tutorial. The same coding we have to copy, the same coding we have to paste on the search also here. Now there's some error. Okay, here some error means here. Have to put one back. So let me go to the deposit. Okay, here I didn't copy this one. If you write catch, try, you must close with the catch. If we are not write the catch, there will be the error. That will be the error. It will be shown in my last error we got. Okay, many here this error will be here. Expect but catch or final is not missing here. Here I wrote only, I paste it only catch only, so that I got the error like that. Okay, if you write catch, you must write the catch also, catch and finally also. If you forget it, you the error will be throw expected catch or finally. Okay, that will be the error. So again I am going to paste it. Okay, this time error was gone. Okay, successfully. Now let's check this particular form only for withdraw form. Go to the program. Here I change as deposit. I'm going to test this only, this form only. So withdraw. Here I'm going to get the account number from my our POB bank account. So that's my bank. Okay, this one here, account. Let me copy this account number and paste it on the account number text box and search. Here the relevant balance will be displayed successfully, so that the relevant balance will be displayed successfully, no problem. Now what I'm going to do is here the search will be working fine. So let's go back to our withdraw things. The same thing I search coding I copied from the deposit. So okay, the same thing, there is no change. It's the same thing I copy and paste here. In withdraw also, double click on the withdraw button and go back to your deposit form again. Here you have to copy the same coding, withdraw button coding, sorry, deposit button coding. Same coding you have to copy. Copy and go back to your withdraw. Double click on the withdraw for button and paste it. Here you no need to change the text box name and everything, because all are same, because I copied this all the controls from the deposit form. Okay, the withdraw form I'm copying all the controls from the deposit form, so that we no need to change anything here. If you click here, the same account, the txt account number text box will be displayed here. The name will be changed like that here, same thing as we did in our deposit here, the same thing. Okay, here only you have to different the text box name there. If you go back to your deposit form, this text box name will be txt dep for deposit. Here you have to change the name as withdraw. Name will be something different, shall be put it VIT. Okay, that's the different. So here only you have to change here deposit, instead of deposit you have to put as withdraw. Here I didn't create the variable of withdraw, deposit withdraw, the same withdraw. That's right. Here also txt withdraw. Okay, here if you change the name here, it automatically change the coding also here. Other if it didn't change, you have to change like that. Here in our last deposit video we wrote here txt dep. Here you have to write txt width is there dot text. That's it, that's the thing you have to write. Now it's perfect. Another one is there, deposit. Okay here instead of deposit update coding, here you have to put withdraw amount. That's it. Here also the table, also transaction tables, also back to our transaction table. Here deposit, here this one will be withdraw. Here this will be when the user deposit the amount, the deposit column will be true. When the user withdraw the amount, this one will be true. So here what I'm going to do is here not the record is not passing to the deposit. When you withdraw the money, the balance will be decreased, and at the same time the transaction will be here. I have to change, instead of the deposit I'm going to change as withdraw. Here the withdraw mean this column will be filled, this is blank. Okay, so change here withdraw. Here also deposit, instead of deposit passing the data also withdraw. But the user enter the withdraw amount on this withdraw text box, this text box, and click withdraw, the amount will be here, this will be decreased, the amount will be decreased and update into your database. Okay let's check if it is work or not. Here withdraw, here deposit, here I add as plus. If it is withdraw, not plus, it is minus. When you withdraw the amount from the bank, the amount will be decreased, not increased. Okay, if it is increased, that will be deposit. If it is decreased, it will be withdraw. Okay, so that I put minus here. Okay, other stuffs are same as I did in deposit. Okay, I just change this thing also, the symbol also I change, and instead of the deposit I put withdraw. Okay, that is the only thing I change, so that I no need to explain from the beginning. Okay, so if I explain this coding from the beginning, it is too much boring for you all. So that I planning to do the course, the what are the things I change from that time explained. Okay, so let me run the program. This is the Victor form. Well, let's copy the account number for the other people's account number. So here, this one here, just copy and paste in this box, click search, work perfectly, and go back here. This one 98,000. Here I am withdrawing 10,000 and click withdraw. Some problem, data withdraw in the field. So okay, the problem will be the column name will be here. I put here is go back to our database. Here go back to our transaction table. Here withdraw, here what I put is here withdraw. That is the problem. You have to write the same name what you wrote here is the same name you have given here. If you leave a single mistake, it will be error. That's the error, it will be thrown. Okay, so here the same thing I paste here, and here search, you can get the given account balance. And if you withdraw 10,000 and click withdraw, you know, transaction success. Let me check the one, the transaction. Okay, the account table, if you check account table here, 98,000 are there. It is reduced the amount 10,000 here. 88,000 is updated. If you go back, if you check the transaction table also, you can hear there is no deposit on this date, this particular date, only withdraw 10,000 withdraw. Okay, the current balance will be 98,000, 10,000 will be withdraw in this particular date, the given account number. Okay, the given account number current balance will be 88,000. Okay, here if you do another stuff for so let me close the form first. Again I'm going to same ID here, the balance will be here, this one. Now again I'm going to get 5,000 and withdraw. Now you can go back to your database and notice that now what is the balance will be here, 5,000 reduced. After that go back to your transaction, this particular date current balance will be here, this one. You withdraw 5,000, all the transaction detail will be available in this transaction database tables. Your transaction, your account numbers with there, what is the date you are withdraw the money, what is the balance, the current date, what is the amount you withdraw, the all the stuff is in the transaction history. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. In my next tutorial I'm going to teach how to make a account to account transaction in banking system. Okay, if you like my channel, subscribe me. Thank you for watching.